Good afternoon, folks. Welcome to our JV basketball game between the Cazenovia Lakers and Bishop Grimes Cobras. We apologize for the late start. We had some technical difficulties with our setup. So maybe this is a good time to remind you that we are the Comm Club. We're a student-led production. Got a 10th grader on the camera, 10th grader running the video board. So
we've got a junior commentating as well.
So learning experience for the players and us. So we thank you for being with us, and we hope you enjoy the game.
Yeah, I mean, right now we're just into the first period. The score is currently tied. We've had a couple foul shots taken, a bunch of shots taken as well. That's to be said.
The JV team's been playing well this year. But this will be a challenge for them. Bishop Grimes, a good team. That was Larry Nessie with the three for the Cobras. That was Balgarang. We apologize if we mispronounce any names. We also didn't get a chance to check in with the Cobras coaches to clarify those. But we'll do our best from the roster. And we're going to get an early timeout for Kaz.
Yeah, I mean, Bishop Grimes has just taken 6 points within, what, 30 seconds?
Yeah, and to be fair, that's about a worst-case scenario outcome. Other team hits a three, they get the steal, and then they hit another three immediately. You know, probably like 9 times out of 10, they're not going to be successful on all three of those.
Right.
But, I mean, you know, it is what it is now, though, when Lakers find themselves in a hole.
Looking at the team there, you can see that Bishop Grimes has about 30 players on their team compared to Kaz's, what is that, 12? 14?
Yeah, a lot of development going on the Cobras side.
That means this game is probably going to turn into more of an endurance game for Kaz, because as Bishop Grimes can trade out all of their players multiple times during the game, Kaz is going to be a bit more limited in that regard.
Yeah, we'll be curious how much of a rotation the Cobras set up.
Doesn't look like we've seen much of that now.
Yeah, for Kaz, I expect to see them go probably somewhere 6 to 8 deep is how they typically play. We'll probably see Kyle Carraher play every single minute. And that's Carraher with the shot, number 13. Paul Mitchell, number 10, we'll see play most of the game.
Another three from Grimes, from Bishop Grimes there.
Rebound for Garang. We got a steal though. Mike Harris Jr. passes it to Paul Mitchell, who will shoot and hit a three. So quick start for the Cobras, but Lakers hanging around.
Long three there by number 15, looks like Larry Nessie.
That'll be at least his second of the game. A little too aggressive on the press for the Cobras there. It's gonna be Javeri Jones-Collins called for the hold. Mm-hmm. Mitchell. Oh, nice pass inside for Danny Bliss. Sends it right back out to Phineas Colby. He'll take a long two. Rebounded by Carraher, but still won't go in.
Ooh.
Nice block for Harris.
And that long three.
Larry Nessie again. So yeah, a break for the Lakers that he missed that one because he was open for it.
Attempted one. Fast break two chance. By Colby. It is going to go in. You didn't necessarily see that, but
have to take our word for it. Yeah, it's going to be a three-point chance. So, and it's Larry Nessie on the line. So even when he scores twos, he scores threes. Well, it's not a given yet. He's got to hit the free throw. We've got some substitutions. Number three, AJ Wade, coming into the game for the Cobras.
That's going to be number 20 and 21, Max Rieger and Jake Schwartz coming in for the Lakers. He's going to make that.
Yeah, it is going to end up being 3 points for Nessie. Mitchell gets it over to Rieger, looking to go back to Mitchell, but it's picked off. Rebounded by Wade, just into the game. And now it's gonna go to Mitchell. Cobras with a little bit of a press, but now they'll back off and set up the half court defense.
That's Mitchell passing to Bliss into Rieger. Back out to Bliss. Bliss with the three, no good.
Jiguis Williams with the rebound for the Cobras. Just under a minute left in the first quarter. Rieger
just towing the line.
Out to Bliss. Carraher. Back to Mitchell. Oh, nice cut for Schwartz. Doesn't shoot. Five on the shot clock. Someone's got to take it. Carraher,
no good.
Crowd thinks he got it off before the buzzer went off, but
didn't go
they
in.
Won't get the call.
I'm gonna take that right back though. 15 seconds left on the clock. Not much time left.
Carraher setting the screen, but Cobra's right on it. Someone's gotta shoot.
List takes the shot. No good.
Chucks it at the basket.
9-21. Not a great start for the Lakers here.
Yeah, certainly not.
I mean, that's just the end of the first quarter. We've definitely got enough time in the rest of the game to make up that lead. In fact, I've seen that happen. So.
Yeah, and while we have a stoppage in play, we'll show you the Lakers roster. And maybe if we have time, the Cobras roster as well. Not quite 30, but 18 players. Cazenovia is going to start the second quarter with the same five that finished the first. Actually, that's not true.
No, they have...
We are going to finish with the subs that finished the first. Schwartz and Rieger still out there. Harris back in for Blitz. And Phineas Colby is in for Paul Mitchell. Quick turn and shoot there by A.J. Dagata. Won't go. Harris with the rebound. Good to see Harris playing again. He had an injury earlier in December that kept him out for our last couple games that we were here for.
Takes care of her. Rieger. Rieger for a two, no good.
It's gonna be another rebound for Williams.
There was no good there.
Yeah, don't you feel like every time Nessie shoots, Lakers fans almost hold their breath?
Yeah, the crowd definitely seems to get a little bit quieter when that's happening. It's a bit more of a tense game right now.
Yeah, ironically, both coaches calling for their players to be more patient during the stoppage. Mitchell's going to check back in for Schwartz. Going to be Mitchell coming up with another steal, but gives it right back to Dagata. Well, Nathan, the good news is Nessie missed another shot. Bad news is he's going to the line. Always tough to scout JV, because no one publishes the stats on the internet or anything.
The first shot is no good.
I'd be curious to see if Nessie's, if this is his normal output, or if he's just off to a great start today.
Second shot will go right in.
New players coming in for the Cobras. Cobras with a press. So far, Lakers handling it. This is Rieger, finds Harris. Mike Harris dribbles inside, dishes it back out to Colby. He'll drive inside, gets it out to Mitchell, to Rieger. Lakers are getting open looks. Someone's going to have to pull the trigger, and Harris does.
First points in the second quarter.
Yeah, nice shot from Mike Harris.
But they're going to counter that right out with another three.
Yeah, that was Jacob Gezzi for the Cobras.
Harris all the way across.
Here's Rieger going inside, but turns around and sends it out again. Here's Carraher driving inside. He'll go for the layup.
And in.
I like that aggression from Carraher. At times the Lakers seem a little timid in the paint, which is understandable. Size mismatchup with the Cobras. But I like Carraher going right at him and daring them to stop him. This will be Aaron Washington on the line for the Cobras.
The shot's going in.
Cobra's pretty solid from the line today.
As far as we've seen, they've been pretty solid all the way around.
Yeah, they came out strong.
Second shot will go in as well. Oh.
Lakers lucky to get that one back. There's a shot from Washington. In and out. And they're going to call Antonio Fletcher, number 14, for an over-the-back foul on Carraher. A little bit of a break for the Lakers. Here's Mitchell, gets it out to Colby. Needs help.
We've been seeing the Cobras do this press a lot. I mean, it's aggressive, but then again, with a lot of players on the team and a lot of substitutions you can make, that's a decent strategy for them.
Yeah, and this is the first year teams are allowed to press. They're not allowed to do it in modified. So understandable why the coaches would be aggressive. You might have ball handlers that aren't used to dealing with the press, or they might pass it to someone who's not used to it. And it's certainly something you want your players to learn how to play against before they get up to varsity. So, not really surprising to see it here, although we have seen it a lot versus the Lakers. It almost seems like every game that they play, the press is the opposing team's plan A.
Now, I haven't seen many games. I've been a bit absent from doing these streams. But have the Lakers also been doing a lot of presses as well?
Not as much as their opponents do. One of the things that Coach Burns really wants to work on is solid half-court defense, make the opposition pass it around, make them take bad shots.
And that, too, is also an effective strategy.
Mm-hmm.
As they say, offense is the best defense, or defense is the best offense. I don't remember how that saying goes right now. I assume it's one of the two.
I think I've heard both at times.
Here's Phineas Colby stepping up the line. First shot goes in. Another much needed point for the Lakers. Second shot is in.
Yeah, what you're seeing now is what I would say is a more typical defense from the Lakers. They really want to work on that half court, make sure every guy is in the right place at the right time. Carraher brings it up, gets it to Mitchell. Mitchell drives inside. And once again, sends it out. Harris misses the shot, but gets his own rebound. Gets it to Mitchell. Mitchell will launch another three. Won't go. Dagata bringing it up for the Cobras. Washington. There's another shot.
Two?
Yeah.
No good. I guess I'll take that back.
If this is...
But Carraher gets it. Carraher on the inside goes
blocked.
For a shot.
And plays like that might be why we see the Lakers making that extra pass back out. That's Antonio Fletcher just creating all kinds of problems for the Laker forwards down there. If this is the first time you're seeing JV, it is a little bit different of a look than what we've seen all season. Number 15, Gavin Wagner, not available today. And he's been playing a lot of minutes for Cavs. Last time we saw the boys, he played every single minute of that game. So you are, I think, seeing some of the effects of his absence.
Yeah, I remember Wagner from last year. If I remember correctly, we saw a lot of that as well last year. So,
yeah, he's a good player. I don't know if the folks at home know, he was playing with some broken fingers earlier in the season.
That so, does not
yeah,
seem
it would be interesting. He's walking around the school during the day with like this big splint on his hand, and you know people would ask him like, Gavin, how long before you can play basketball again? He's like, oh, I'm playing now. But. Fortunately for the Lakers, not today. It's AJ Wade.
It's Mitchell out to Bliss. It's no good. The Cobras take it back.
Those are the shots the Lakers have to take to get back in the game. You need to maximize the possessions.
And that was Borgerang.
He's going to have a chance for a three-point play. And we're going to get a timeout first.
Another timeout called by the Lakers. Makes sense, seeing that they're...
Yeah, often in these games, you'll see the team that's down being the ones to use more timeouts.
Makes sense.
And part of it is strategy. If you see your opponent getting some momentum, want to, you know, cool them off a little bit, maybe try to get their heads out of the game. Although I think a big reason for this one is drawing up the plan for the last 92 seconds of the half. Ideally, what the Lakers are going to want to see here is hold them at 36, which probably means getting them to miss two, maybe three shots, and at the same time maximizing your opportunities at the other end.
Right. Once again, this is Volgarang at the line for one shot. And it is not good.
Good. So there's the first break for the Lakers. That was Alex Yavorsky with the rebound. This will be Mitchell. Colby finds Yavorsky. Looking for help, finds Mitchell.
Mitchell.
Back to Colby.
Colby passes to Bliss.
Someone's got to shoot, 5 seconds on the clock. And the Lakers aren't going to get it off.
There was an attempt.
Yeah. Yavorsky just getting it and chucking it at the backboard. Hey, you know what they say, you can't win the lottery if you don't play.
He's trying to hold the Cobras here.
Cobras also slowing it down
going
a little
in,
bit.
And they could not do
Here's
it.
Wade.
It's going to take another 2 points. 30 seconds left on the clock. Shot clock is off now.
Twist finds Harris. Mitchell. Goes inside to Yavorsky.
Up and...
Yeah, and I like what Yavorsky did there. Like, you can't let the size matchup intimidate you. You will get blocked sometimes, but if you're aggressive, you can draw those fouls too.
And for that, I'll be stepping up to the line.
It's the first
shot will go in. It's good. Two more points.
Here come the Cobras.
Cobras going
nice
straight
pass.
In. Bulgarang with a good two-pointer. Half-court shot. More than half-court, but...
Yeah, that was an impressive play for the Cobras just before the buzzer. Very varsity-like play. Point guard brings it up, gets that quick pass to the tallest guy sneaking in and hits the layup.
And we're going to head into the halftime with a score of 18-40.
And we'll take a break and rejoin you in the second half.
Zander walks up to you and says, I know people who are your friends, who are already looking for you. And patience and stuff.
Thank you. Well, I guess the fans might be a little annoyed if they never live stream the victory. But we've never live streamed this season. Like, we saw some. Have we never live streamed the victory this year?
No, we saw about.
We've just seen fewer losses for basketball.
Yes. Wait, no. First, the basketball last time they won. When it was me, being new Sebastian, and
yeah. I was there for that one.
No, you left, but. No, it was JB lost with the one. Don't remember, but I'm sure it was because first two there were neck and neck and start playing because they pulled their hand and they gained the game. But JB
probably have more people.
Broadcast.
All right, welcome back. If you're just joining us, it's the Bishop Grimes Cobras jumping out to a big lead in the first half. Cazenovia really struggling to get shots off inside, and so that's forced them to play more to the perimeter. And, you know, three-pointers give and take away. But they'll try to start off strong here in the third quarter. This is Paul Mitchell going inside to Kyle Carraher, who shoots, won't get the layup. Gets it out to Colby. Cobra's looking to trap, but Lakers escape it. Not sure how much our microphone down there is picking up, but Cobra's coach looking for his team to play a little more aggressively. Disappointed that they almost had a trap, but couldn't come up with the ball. And here's Carraher with another shot. This time he'll get it. Watch out for that guy. That's Larry Nessie. If you didn't see the first half, he hit 2 3-pointers. Yeah, at least 2. And also had a 3-point play from down low too. So he's having himself a good game today. Neat move there down there by A.J. Wade, but couldn't make the shot.
The Cobras not pressing as much as they did in the first half.
Yeah, and part of that may be a gentleman's agreement. Usually if you're up big, you call off the dogs a little bit. Or it may just be that they want to work on a different defense here in the second half.
Especially since they have a little wiggle room at this point.
Yeah, and time with no scoring. We had one free throw.
We'll see Karaher step up to the line here. First one is no good. This is a substitution.
Andy Franz into the game.
Care of her. Second shot is no good. Cobras get that. They're gonna make a three-pointer.
Yeah, that was Cam Tong, who just checked into the game, so. A little bit of a fan favorite for the Cobras fans in the building.
Lakers are gonna make a two, right back at him. That's Karaher subbing out for Yavorsky.
Yep, and it's gonna be Will Mills coming in for Schwartz. We've also got Max Crawford, number four, into the game. So, Coach Burns emptying the bench on this one. That's Yavorsky. Finds Mitchell. Three won't go.
No,
oh, that's Andrew Tyler, not Max Crawford, number four, but he's in. Tyler again. Finds Mitchell over to Mills. Yavorsky. Driving inside. Dishes it back out to Tyler. Mitchell. Yavorsky.
Yavorsky's going in. Out.
Tyler with a three, and he'll hit it.
Points are needed right now, but with only a minute and a half left in the game, it's not looking great.
Gets them into the box score, though, if they did box scores for JV. Here's Mitchell looking for Yavorsky. That was Ben Carroll who got a hand on it, big number 50. Here comes Mitchell, drives inside, takes the shot.
Won't go.
Bouncing around. It's going to be Tong coming up with the rebound. And this is Mike Sales bringing it up. Tong with a shot again.
And it'll go in.
Wow, where has this guy been all game? 2 for 2 from three.
A lot of late game threes we've seen from the Cobras now. Very late game, especially.
Got some substitutions for both teams. This will be Rieger bringing it up. Mills setting a screen. Rieger brings it around, finds Tyler. Out to Mills. Back to Tyler. Here comes Rieger again, finds Tyler. Takes the shot, gets it back, drives inside now. Nice vision from Andrew Tyler, found Yavorsky for two.
The Cobras are not waiting this one out. They're gonna attempt another shot.
Nice block there from Mills, and that'll do it.
And that is the end of the game.
So final score, Bishop Grimes 64, Cavs Lakers 44.
Bishop Grimes was only taking a 20-point lead during that game.
Yeah.
As bad as it was.
Good play for the Lakers in the fourth quarter. And we'll take a little bit of a break while the varsity teams warm up, and then we'll have that game for you here on this same channel. So stick around.